move back. Come on, give us some space, please.
Turn? Severe cuts to the thigh.
Serious?
Well, he lost a lot of blood, but he survived.
Sheriff, please.
Come on. Has he said anything?
Not much. He's in shock. Hardly surprising. He did say it was a machete before he went under.
Tony, can you stay here? June, you ready? Gary, yes. Come here. In the back of the ambulance.
Right, yeah.
Right, come on. Let's go. Right, everybody keep still. Sit down. Who's the licensee? You the landlord?
Could be.
Do you put a call in?
Didn't ask for you. Just the ambulance.
What happened?
Nothing.
Oh, that's why bloke's being stretched out, is it?
Just a brawl.
With a machete?
Well, how long is this going to take? I was supposed to pick my kids up 20 minutes ago.
Yeah, if you could just sign there,
Dave,
please.
Dave, have you seen Steve?
In the yard, I think, Sarge.
Come through, will you? This is the front office. It's the interface with the general public.
40 minutes this has taken. My kids are waiting for me.
All right, Dave.
I'm very sorry.
I mean, do you think I'm a criminal? You know, if I had more time, I'd make an official complaint.
Go through, will you? I'll be right with you.
I'm sorry, sir.
Not now, Dave. And do try to stop them leaving their shopping behind, will you?
Let's get this quite straight, Phil. You're standing less than 10 feet away from a man who's being attacked with a machete and you don't see a thing, huh?
I told you I was facing the other way.
And you didn't hear anything?
Jukebox was playing, wasn't it? Look, I'd help if I could. But I like my legs the way they are, you know what I mean? Attached to the rest of me.
Hey, Joy.
I'll say one thing for this lot, and they're consistent. No one saw or heard anything.
We could just take a lot of them down the nick, sir. Bound to shake something out of somebody.
No, we'll not get a squeak out of this bunch.
Anything on the victim?
Haven't got a name. But Gary's gone down to St. Hugh's with him.
Right. I'll go and get me grapes.
Well, depending on the quality, I'd guess about 60 grand's worth.
Someone somewhere's going to be a bit upset.
Yeah. Look good on the seizure list, though, eh, Susie? So, who we got for it, Dave?
Well, I don't know, Sarge. I didn't see.
You were having a kip?
It was very busy.
Dave, you're supposed to be keeping your eyes open. Especially when someone's dropping off 2 kilos of coke.
Yes, Sarge.
Gary, anything?
Nah, not even a snore, Gov.
Any idea who he is?
Well, he wasn't very talkative on the way in. I can't say I blame him, though. His leg was a real mess.
Found anything in his pockets?
Nothing helpful. He wasn't short of a penny, though. The mystery man, eh, Gov?
Well, not quite. His name's Rogers. Len Rogers.
But you know him?
Used to. A small-time driver. You never had any money, Len. Getting cut up is not your style, so what have you been up to?
Mrs. Hayes, did you leave anything behind at the station this afternoon?
No.
Could you describe any of the other people in the waiting area?
Why?
Some property was left behind. We're trying to trace the owner.
Is that how you spend your time, acting as a lost property office?
Well, it wasn't just an umbrella, Mrs. Hayes. But if you could think back, I would really appreciate it.
Right. There was a drunk.
Yes.
And then there were a couple of kids who kept on messing about. No manners.
Anyone else?
A fellow came in, but he didn't wait. I mean, you can't blame him, because he'd probably still be there.
This man, could you describe him?
I'll say this for you, Harry. They're always on time.
Mr. Deakin.
Len Rogers, Harry.
Can't help you there, Mr. Deakin.
Oh, no, come on, Harry. You can do better than that. I've always looked after you, haven't I?
I won't say you haven't. But I'm no grass. You know that.
I'm not saying you're a grass. I'm not asking you to be a grass. I just need some help. If not for me, then for Len.
I don't see him no more. Not for months.
Had a falling out, have you?
Just went our different ways.
Ben's in trouble. He got chopped. And that led me to wonder what a small-time villain like him was doing with a big mob after him. And then I thought of his old mate, Harry.
Like I said, I don't see him. Len's out of his depth. He needs help. I don't know what he's been up to, just he's had a lot of money recently.
Any jobs in particular?
Been driving for some flash geezer. You know, chauffeuring.
What, you didn't like your partner going straight?
No, it's not like that.
Well, what is it like, Harry?
All I heard is he miffed a major player and did a runner. Now, that's all I know. Is he going to be all right?
He'll pull through.
I told him not to get involved. Prat.
So now you do remember the drunk?
Yeah. Yeah. I guess.
You guess?
Well, Sarge, how many times have I got to tell you it was Chucker?
Dave, what's it coming to? Well, a member of the public's got a better memory than a trained police officer.
Sarge.
Don. Where's Susie?
She's in custody, Gov. Right. Let's go over it again, shall we?
Susie, you got a minute?
Go.
We're to cross-reference the disqualified drivers index with our local villains.
What am I looking for?
Anyone who's been disqualified in the past couple of months might be needing a show.
Sure.
That's quite all. All snouts are paying off.
Not exactly. Somebody handed it in at the front desk.
What, handed in that lot?
Yeah, I doubt if it was theirs to give. Imagine the owner's pretty unhappy.
Yeah.
This is useless. I told DSP to everyone I saw. They just cuff up for cameras.
Can't do that. That'd be too easy.
Well, how was I supposed to see him? The place was heaving, and the description he gave me. White male wearing gloves, a cap, and a black jacket that might have been brown.
It was brown, actually.
What?
The jacket was brown.
You saw him?
Yeah, when I came through earlier.
What? Well, could you give us a description?
Do better than that. I'll give you a name. Mike Secker. Old school villain, retired now.
Well, why didn't you tell DS Beach?
Because I'm an old softy. Don't just sit there, go and find him.
Thanks, Rachel.
Sarge.
No, don't tell me. You can remember the colour of his socks now.
The bloke's name's Mike Secker. He's got form running back years.
Well done. They are. I told you all you had to do was concentrate. Sit down. You deserve a cup of tea.
Don, you're working on this cocaine thing, aren't you?
Yes, Gov.
A couple of hours ago, a bloke called Len Rogers was attacked in the Railway Bell. Now, word has it he's been driving for a villain. I just wondered if the two things might be connected. Yeah. Think he could be the dealer?
Well, it might be. But he's definitely not the guy who dropped the gear off.
You've identified him?
Yeah. You want me to fill you in, Gov? Thanks.
Sarge?
Secker's got form as long as your arm, Gov. But nothing for drugs. Besides, word is, he's retired.
Except when it comes to a couple of kilos of coke.
Yeah.
You sure about this?
Apparently it's where he spends all his time, studying for a degree.
DS Beach, D.I. Deakin, Sun Hill. Can we have a word?
Shh. How did you know it was me? Cameras, right?
Yeah, something like that.
Can't move without you lot spying on us.
Where did you get the bag, Mr. Secker?
Found it.
Where?
I just found it.
And you decided to do the public-spirited thing?
Got the stuff off the street, didn't I?
Why didn't you wait and make a formal statement?
Because I knew what it would be like. When? Where? Why?
Surprised you didn't keep it. Man with your connections, shift that lot in an afternoon.
I'm retired, aren't I? Besides, I don't have no truck with drugs. I never have.
I see you're taking a degree, Mr. Secker. Very commendable.
Never too late to learn.
They give you a grant.
I've money put by.
So what's it in, eh? Don't tell me. Criminal psychology.
Ethics. I wouldn't expect you to understand.
Do you know Len Rogers?
No.
Are you sure? Tall man, middle-aged. Got badly cut up this afternoon.
Look, I don't know him, all right. Anyway, what is all this? I haven't done nothing. I helped you out.
Well, I don't think we're not grateful, Mr. Secker. We are, aren't we, Don?
Yeah. Eternally.
All that stuff taken off the street. It's got to be good, isn't it? The thing is, no one's been put out of business, have they? Now, if you were to remember where you found that bag, we could do some real damage, if you follow me.
What do I get out of it?
How about peace and quiet? They like that in libraries.
I'd need some guarantees.
Within reason?
No fallout for me.
Okay.
It was on a car I done.
I thought you'd retired.
Look, it was a special request, particular make and model, you know. And I saw one, perfect. Range Rover Vogue, SE3.9. Right on the button.
Do we have a word?
What?
Do we have a word?
Hang on a minute.
Oi!
Detective Inspector Deakin, this is Detective Sergeant Beach from Sun Hill.
Yeah? What do you want me to do about it?
It's fine if we have a walk round.
Got a search warrant.
Don, have we got a search warrant?
Cut. You lot.
Gonna threaten me with heavies, are ya? Hey? Won't wash, I know my rights.
Oh dear, look what I've just found.
Do you find it's all in order?
Right here, Gov.
What is it with you? Not enough crack dealers out there. Time to fill.
Don't know why you're bothering. It's all legit.
Gov!
Told ya. It's all kosher.
Can you give me a PNC?
Didn't you like the colour?
Look, I bought that motor in good faith. Got a receipt, logbook, the works.
Of course you have. Just as these days, you can't be too careful. There's so many cowboys about.
Not reported stolen, but get this, registered to a J.F. Sullivan.
Jason Sullivan?
It's gotta be.
Well, if Rogers was driving for Sullivan, he was way out of his depth.
I bet he got the shock of his life when he came out of that bookies.
No car, no dope.
Why didn't Sullivan finish him off?
Warning. He will the next time if he doesn't get his gear back.
Constable,
I see you're looking after our land.
Seems to be making remarkable progress.
But then, it wasn't too serious, was it? It could have been much worse if they'd really meant business.
Don't forget to crush the stands, Len.
Last longer that way.
Friend of yours?
Tough.
I can't drink this.
I'm sorry, mate, that's the way it comes. Here.
Do us a favour.
See if you can get some sugar, yeah?
We'd like it in bone china as well.
Gary, where's the patient?
Awake and already complaining.
Surely Sullivan wouldn't try anything on in here.
Why not? He did in a crowded pub.
Maybe he's being looked at.
His clothes are gone.
Where's Rogers? I was only gone a second.
That's all he needed.
Oh, terrific.
Gary, go back in. He can still be inside. We'll take a look round. Don, do you want to go down the side? I'll take the car. He kind of got far with that leg.
We were fright, did we?
What was that, I wonder?
Give him a lift, shall we, Gov? Come on. Come on.
Go on, hold me.
I ain't done that.
Mate, it's talking about holding your limb. We just want to ask you a couple of questions.
There, cop hold.
Get your leg over, come on.
I don't know nothing.
So? There you are, stood at the bar having a pint. And up comes this bloke and literally buries a hatchet and you don't know anything about it.
It's a dodgy area.
You didn't see who it was, not even a glimpse.
Have you ever been macheted? It sort of takes your mind off other things.
Why'd you do a runner?
I wasn't under arrest, was I?
All right.
What, is that it?
Well, like you said, we can't hold you.
Yeah, right.
12 Larchmont Drive, isn't it?
No, that... It's okay. You can drop me off here.
Well, in your condition, we're not heartless, are we?
A couple of pussycats.
I said it's okay!
Why are you frightened to go home, Len? Worried there might be a party, a surprise one. Sullivan.
You know, don't you?
What do we know? I'll tell you what, Lynn. Why don't you tell us exactly what we know, and then there won't be any misunderstandings.
I come out of the bookies, I saw the motor was gone, and I panicked.
So you went for a drink?
I didn't know what else to do. I mean, I thought if I could get the stuff back, he'd need never know. So I started to ask around, put the word about.
Don't tell me you were going to offer a reward.
I didn't get a chance, did I? I was in the railway bell talking to some old blagger when Sullivan comes storming in.
What did he say?
Nothing. Just a look, and then whack, whack. And out.
Still, let you off rather lightly, really, didn't he?
Oh, yeah. Do you want to see what he did?
If Sullivan had meant business, he'd have chopped off both legs and sent them home to Mum, wouldn't he? So how come he just give you a scratch?
How should I know?
Do you want me to spell it out for you? He thinks you've still got the gear, and he would like it back.
But I've never even seen it!
It's not what Sullivan thinks.
What am I supposed to do then? I mean, he knows where I live. He'll find me. I can't even walk!
Gov, can I have a word?
Oh, Mr. Deakin! You know me. I'm not big time. I'm just Len.
You'll be right here, for the time being.
Yep.
If Sullivan is giving him a chance, that gives us a chance too, Gov.
What do you mean?
Well, we've got the car and we've got the package. Put them together, what does it make? Mouse trap and bait, Gov. Mouse trap and bait.
Use Len to set it up.
He tells Sullivan he's got the car back and the gear. We just wait for Sullivan to collect, that's all.
Could be a bit dodgy, Don. We'd have to show guilty knowledge.
Do what?
We'd have to see him, know what's in the bag, and then knowingly handle it. Without that, any half-arse brief is going to get away from 5 minutes.
Well, we just have to be very careful then, won't we?
And if Len won't cooperate?
He has got no choice, has he? If he doesn't, we just put it out that, well, we found the gear on him. Sullivan won't give him two chances, will he?
We've decided that you're going to cooperate with us. Now, you know how to use one of these, don't you?
No, no, no way.
Sullivan's expecting a phone call, Len. If he doesn't get one... Well, it's not going to just be a leg, is it?
You can't do this.
Just give him a call. Tell him you found the motor, all the gear's inside, and you're going to bring it round to his club. Or maybe you'd rather go home.
Hope you know what you're doing, Chris.
If any way we're going to nail him, sir. Sullivan's been running rings around us for years. It's the first time he's slipped up.
Yes, well, if this goes wrong, how am I going to explain us putting 2 kilos of cocaine back on the street? The press will have a field day.
We'll be under constant surveillance, sir. Stuff won't be out of our sight for a minute.
If this blows up, we'll be looking for a new DI.
Sir, there won't be any problems.
Let's hope not.
DS Daily from DI Deakin.
Go ahead, Gov.
Should be turning into Oak Street now.
Got him, Gov.
God, dear. Go on, Lenny, go on!
Right. Now, everyone knows the procedure. We have got to see Sullivan clock the bag, and then we tail
him till he makes his next move, all right?
Received.
Here we go, Gov. Come on. Come on, look at the bag.
Oh, don't believe it. Get out the way.
Gotcha.
Yes. He's done it.
Like I said, Gov, mouse, trap and bait.
Suspect heading north along Oak Street.
Yeah, okay, we'll pick him up in Green Lane.
Taking a left into William Street. Repeat, left into William Street.
Yep, received. Don't lose sight of him. Don't lose sight of him.
Turning left into Shaw Street.
Okay.
Lost him, Gov. Suspect believed still to be travelling south on Shaw Street.
Oh, damn it. Cut through Saunders Street, can I, Gov? Jeff, what's going on? Yeah, Danny.
Sorry, Gov, lost him.
Oh, marvellous.
Well, shall I move him on?
No, if he sees us, he'll drop everything.
Well, it's either that or put 60 grand with a coat back on the road.
Oh, don't worry, Don, I signed it out in your name.
Huh?
Hang on. That's him over there, isn't it? Pull over. Go on.
Come on, get the bag.
Come on. Great, he's got it.
Is this your vehicle?
Ah, that's all we need.
Don't do your job too well, son. Hope he stays cool. Give us a bag to Reg, we've lost him. Anyway, look what I just found in the bag of it.
I hear any excuses. If I don't get this to him,
it'll go through the roof. I'd be very grateful.
Yeah, all right. Look. 2 minutes.
Honestly, you saved my skin.
There we go.
Oh, sir. Sir, anything I can help with?
Oh, thanks, Reg. You've done your bit.
Shall we wait for backup, Gov?
No, we'll lose it. Come on.
Where'd you
think
you're going?
Police.
Hang on a
minute. Come here, you wait down.
Wait down.
Just
stay there.
Mr. Sullivan.
Detective Inspector Deakin, Sunhill.
Ah, Inspector, how can I help? If it's about the car, I explained to the constable that I was going to be 2 minutes
no more. Sullivan?
Look, enough.
All right.
In a minute. Where's the bag? I'm sorry.
Try and open that door, please.
I'm sorry, I don't have a key. I'm the owner, not the manager.
Looks like we found your bag.
I'm sorry, I don't follow.
All right, sir. You're nicked.
Look, Inspector, don't make a fool of yourself. I know it's disappointing, but you've got nothing, all right? Never have done, never will do.
You're denying all knowledge of the contents of that bag.
Guilty knowledge, right? Nice try, but I've never seen it before in my life. You can write that down if you like. The suspect was surprised and horrified.
That's funny. Because we've got excellent photos of you taking that bag out of your car. Big enough surprise for you.